Go. Hey everybody, Bible Thumpin' Jay here with another good Bible study. So in this Bible study, the question is, does baptism save you or does it not? Well, you already know how I feel about it, but I'm going to go through the scriptures and let y'all decide if baptism saves you or not. So in this video, we're going to see what happens to the ones who believe in Jesus, which means to obey, and what happens if they get baptized compared to the ones who reject baptism, which is rejecting the Father's will. They don't tell you that one. And what happens if they do not believe the words of Jesus. So with that being said, let's understand the importance and details of baptism. Let's get started now. So, all right. First of all, in the book of Mark up here, verse 16 or chapter 16, verse 15 and 16, this is the day Jesus rose from the dead, straight from the mouth of Jesus when he just got done rising from the dead to establish his commands. It's what he died for. He says to them, go into all the world and preach gospel to every creature, me and you, everybody. He who, in two simple steps, here's the gospel. Whoever believes, you got to believe he rose from the dead, which proves he's the Son of God, which means every word he speaks is truth, unless they call him a liar, so don't do that. And the truth is, he says, if you, number two, you get baptized, you will be saved. So when you get baptized, the works of baptism applied to your faith will make your faith perfect because you show God you love him. For the ones who do not believe will be condemned. So in the second part of this video, I'll tell you exactly, right down to the nitty-gritty detail, why they condemn themselves when they refuse baptism. But let's focus on the good parts first. So, whoever believes and is baptized will be saved. So let's say that we have a believer, because this is the believing part here, right? Where's my pen at? There it is. Okay. So, the gospel is he who believes and baptized will be saved. So, if you get baptized, this is Jesus. So, Jesus confirms baptism now saves you. So, baptism, which corresponds to this, now saves you. This is one of many reasons why baptism saves you. But let me break this down. So, not as a removal of dirt from the body, but as an apparel to God for a good conscience through the resurrection of Jesus Christ. So when you get baptized, the waters, don't bring soap with you. It's not getting a bath, okay? It has nothing to do with cleaning dirt from your body, but it doesn't even really, it's not really much of a physical thing. It's more of a spiritual thing. You're showing God, not other people, you're showing God a good conscience toward the resurrection of Jesus Christ. However one responds to the holy commandment of baptism will determine them by their fruits. They'll have the fruit of obedience, getting baptized, they love Jesus, and the fruits of disobedience, when they disregard his word, they don't love him, reject the Father's will. That's a bad conscience toward the resurrection of Jesus. So make sure you get baptized. You'll see why. So anyway, show God a good conscience toward the death and resurrection of Jesus Christ. So we're going to break down this story, actually. So baptism, which corresponds to what? It's the Noah story. So let me break it down real quick what this all means. Okay, so first of all, in 1 Peter, chapter 3, verse 18 through 21, this scripture up here. It's the same thing, but it's broken down. So let's bring it in context. So it says, for Christ also suffered once for sins, the just for the unjust, that he might bring us to God, being put to death in the flesh, that's when he died, and made alive by the Spirit when he rose from the dead. By whom also he went and preached to the spirits in prison, who formerly were disobedient. Okay, so according to the baptism today compared to the Noah days, the ones who were disobedient to God are the ones who formerly disobeyed. So that represents the people of today. Whoever is disobedient to the holy commandment of baptism, which is rejection of the Father's will, instead of being saved by water, if they refuse water baptism, they're basically going to die by water. But this time around, it won't be water. It'll be the final judgment. And so the ones who formerly disobeyed represents the people today who disobey baptism. And so this happened back in the Noah days. Again, when once the divine long-suffering waited in the days of Noah while the ark was being prepared, in which a few, that is eight souls, were saved through water. Okay, so unlike the ones who disobeyed, who were not saved, the ones who drowned in the flood of the world, Noah, on the other hand, he had faith in God, and he applied the works of God's command, building an ark, and by works his faith was made perfect. He became a friend of God because he loved them by keeping his commands. And only because Noah obeyed God was Noah and his family saved through the water, because they was on the boat saved. So that's back then how Noah and his family was saved through water. So what Noah represents today is, instead of God commanding us to build an ark like Noah, instead God commands us to be baptized by water so we can have our version being saved through water. Similar to Noah, but we don't need to build a boat. We just need to go down in the water, get baptized, and you receive the Holy Spirit that guarantees you heaven. I'll explain that in a minute. So in other words, if we obey God's command, doesn't matter what the command is. If we obey God's command, not the law of works, but the law of faith, God's command. If we obey God's command like Noah, we will be saved through water, similar to Noah. But if we disobey God's command of baptism, which would represent the disobedient who formerly disobeyed and died in the flood, those are the ones who reject the Father's will by disobeying baptism. But either way, that's what it represents, and Noah and his family was saved through water. So therefore, as the scripture goes on, there is also an antitype which now saves us, baptism. The antitype corresponds to the Noah story. Noah obeyed, the ones who died in the flood were disobedient. Obey baptism or disobey. Obedience is believe. Disobedience is they do not believe, which is unbelief. Okay, so that's why baptism now saves you. So again, let me, I guess I could get my pen back out. That ain't gonna work. Okay, so let me do this. Okay, so again, so whoever believes and is baptized will be saved. So Jesus confirms baptism saves you. Anyone that says it doesn't, they're teaching the complete opposite of the Bible. A lot of heresies out there, people. If they say the opposite of what God says, they're liars. So, and then the next one here is, Jesus answered, most assuredly I say to you, unless one is born of water, baptism, and the Spirit, Holy Spirit, he cannot enter the kingdom of heaven. So, let me say this first real quick, because there's going to be conflict with a lot of deceivers out there. Many people think born of water means through the womb of a woman. Whoever thinks reborn or born of water is through the womb of a woman, they're just as confused as Nicodemus. Nicodemus's problem was he was thinking earthly, physical things instead of heavenly things, because he was not first seeking the kingdom of God, which is heavenly and spiritual. He was focused, his mind was on physical, earthly things. So when you hear the word born of water or reborn, first physical thought of earthly things is through a womb of a woman. But if you're thinking spiritually, born of water doesn't mean womb of a woman. It means a spiritual response to God's holy command of baptism, which born of water we just went through. Baptism saves you because you're responding to God, not other people, but God's commands, not mankind's command, but God's command. So being born of water is not only a physical action, but it's a spiritual action towards God. You're showing him a good conscience from your heart. It's not so much of the physical, it's your heart. But baptism is the way to go. So when you get born of water, I want to explain exactly what this means. This is very important. Very important. Okay, so when you get born of water, I want to tell you exactly what the outward symbol. This outward symbol is actually, okay, is the born of water. So first of all, we're going to go down here, right? So when we're born of water, we go down in the water. This represents being buried in the ground, but yet water, right? So you're repenting from your saying, hey God, I'm showing you I love you by keeping your command of baptism. So when you go down in the water, you're dying in your old sinful self, meaning you're going to leave your old sinful self behind because you're dying in your sins, which is representing the death of Jesus. When Jesus died, right? He got buried or in the tomb. This represents that when we get born of water. So we go down in the water, represents the death of Jesus Christ. And when we come out of the water, we leave our sinful life down here. So we're out of the water now, and this comes up. And when we come up out of the water, this is why it's called born of water. Because when you come out of the water, you become a new creature, kind of like a newborn baby, a new babe in Christ. A new creature. Now you're off to a clean slate with the Lord because you showed you love him by keeping his commands, and he justifies you for being justified by the works of the Father's will. Not by faith alone. Not by faith alone, people. Sorry, doesn't Bible don't teach that. So when you get born of water, you go down and die with Christ. You come up and come alive with Christ. And this is the outward symbol you're showing God. You're showing God this, not people. Don't worry about what people think. Who cares about them? They ain't going to save you. God is. He wants to know, however you respond to the Holy Command of baptism will determine you whether if you have good fruit tree or a bad fruit tree. Disobedience or obedience. Pick your poison. Anyway, when you get born of water, you're only shown an outward symbol to God. And this is doing, it's also changing you on the inside because you're responding in a good conscience, okay? So once you are representing that, you're made alive in the spirit. So when you come out of the water, you're a new creature. And because you had your faith working through love, God gives you some love back when he gives you the Holy Spirit as promised. And once the Holy Spirit enters you, it changes you on the inside. So basically, when it changes you on the inside, what you're doing, you're putting on Christ, you're putting the truth in you. Remember when Jesus says, "Lo, I will be with you always"? The reason why he said that, because when he gave his disciples the Holy Spirit is Jesus. Father, Son, Holy Spirit, one God. And the Holy Spirit goes in you. And when the Holy Spirit goes in you, remember, God is love. So God gives you a piece of him, his love. If you have the Holy Spirit, you have the Son. If you have the Son, you have the Father. And they're with you, helping you. That's why it's called the Helper. So the reason why you come alive with Christ, because he gives you his Holy Spirit. And like I said, that's putting on Christ. Let me go through the scriptures here so I don't keep repeating myself. Okay, so this is the interchange, what's going on. Okay, well, I just want to do, okay, so when you're born of water, you're getting buried with him through baptism into death. If you got baptized, you died with Christ. If you're not baptized, you didn't die with Christ. So born of water is being buried with Christ, as we just explained. So here we go. When we put on the Lord Jesus Christ, this is born. So when you have the Holy Spirit in you, the Holy Spirit comes down upon you, and that's Jesus Christ going in you. You're putting on Christ. Lo, he's with you always. That's this Holy Spirit with you that takes you back to heaven when you die. Make sure you get baptized. So you put on Christ. That's another interchange. And then, where am I at here? Okay. So yeah. So what happens here? Here's the interchange. Here's how the interchange works. When... Let me do this. Okay, so here's the interchange right here, right? So when you get baptized, you receive this Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit completes you. First, step one, complete. So right now, God created us a three-part being. We only have two parts. We have to go to God to get the third. So we have a soul inside of our physical body. We have a soul and body. Once we get baptized, we receive our third final part. Boom, that's your Holy Spirit. So you have a soul, body, spirit, one person. Just like the Father, Son, Holy Spirit, one God. See how we work together? So pick up your cross daily, people. It's a work. Anyway, once you receive the Holy Spirit, you got your third part. You're three in one, and it completes you. You're not complete until you get that third part that completes you, right? Three in one. Just like that solves the mystery of the Godhead. But anyway, whole nother story. So once you get the Holy Spirit, Jesus with you, the truth in you, the Holy Spirit will help perfect you. Like by your works of baptism, your faith is made perfect. You receive the Holy Spirit. It completes you. And it keeps you repentant from your sins. And it maintains you as a loving person. So this is the faith that grows in you. So you get the Holy Spirit. And it helps you stay repentant from your sins. And it helps you make a practice of not lawlessness. You repent from that. But it helps make you a practice of walking in the Spirit. Love, joy, peace, faithfulness, and all that. And as the Holy Spirit helps perfect you in your faith as the years go by, as the time goes by, the more you follow the guidance of the Holy Spirit, the more the Holy Spirit, the more good works you do, the more evil it overtakes. So the Holy Spirit is overtaking your fleshly desires. And once the Holy Spirit, boom, overtakes the flesh, you are now holiness. Because you're walking in holiness. Because your spirit, the Holy Spirit, has helped you overtake your flesh. You are in self-control of your life. And Jesus, by doing this, has set you free from sin. and sin will have no dominion over you as long as you walk in the Spirit. And as long as you walk in the Spirit, which is walking in love, that's what it means to walk in faith. Because the law of faith is one word, love. And that's what the Holy Spirit is when it goes in you. So it's love conquering your evil sins. If you don't do good works, your evil will overtake your spirit, and that represents evil. But when the Spirit of the Holy Spirit overtakes your flesh, your spirit's in control, that represents holiness. Be holy, for he is holy, and that's why he commands us to be baptized so we receive the Holy Spirit that makes us holy. Three in one, complete, and perfects our faith as we go. Yeah! Go Jesus! You better go get some Jesus! Lo, he's with you always! You ain't got baptized, you ain't got that Holy Spirit, you ain't got the Lord. Go get him now. Come on. All right, moving on. So, this is how born of water and of Spirit perfects your faith. Okay, so you get born of water, water baptism. When you rise out of that water, the Holy Spirit comes upon you, and it makes you three in one, perfects you, because it helps you. It's like a guide. Anytime you're about to sin, let me say this real quick. This is what the Holy Spirit does. Like the laws of works of the past, it does not justify you, but the laws of faith, commandments of Jesus, does. So instead of relying on the laws of works of the past back then, the laws of works was only put in place to make, so because the laws of works was put in place to make us aware if we were sinning or not. And the laws of works, once we knew we were sinning based on the laws of works, we knew to repent from that sin. It's like a speed limit sign. If you go to speed limit, there's no reward. But if you blow it, there's consequences. Okay, so that's the laws of works. The laws of works is just to do what you're already supposed to be doing. There's no reward for doing what you're already made to do, good works. That's why you don't get saved by good works, because we're made to do good works. We're being saved from sin that stopped us from doing good works. We get free from sin, we go back to God's plan and do good works. Another story. Anyway, I forget what I was saying. Dang it. Oh, okay. If you're not, okay, so people say born of water is through the womb of a woman. So there's three things now. You make sure if you're not born of a womb of a woman, you're not going to heaven according to scripture. So we'll throw the, it's usually faith alone that tries to reject baptism. But anyway, we'll throw them a bone. Let's say born of water is through the womb. Okay, if you're not born of water, you don't go to heaven. If you're not born of spirit, you don't go to heaven. Guess what? If you don't get baptized, you don't go to heaven either. Because rejecting baptism is a rejection of the Father's will. Just like if you reject being born of a womb of a woman, you don't go to heaven. Reject baptism, same thing. I'm claiming born of a water is water baptism. That's pretty much common sense. If you think spiritual things, heavenly things, you're not talking about born through the womb of a woman, okay? That's earthly thinking. So read the whole story. Anyway, let's continue. I just want to read this one more. Okay, James 1, verse 2 and 8 before we move on. My brethren, oh, that's a saved Christian. You know why it's brethren? Because after they're baptized, that's when you believe, duh, which means you're saved. Okay, let's continue. My brethren, who's already baptized, right? Count it all joy when you fall into various trials. When you get the Holy Spirit, remember, Jesus got baptized, got the Holy Spirit. He went to the desert. He was tempted by the devil. Expect the same. Fight the good fight. Watch out for the wiles of the devil. So you will fall into various trials, but that's why you need the Holy Spirit and baptize. You got the Holy Spirit. It's going to let you know when the devil's trying to deceive you. That's why you got to get the Holy Spirit. You can't do it by yourself. You need to get Jesus, the Holy Spirit, with you. If you don't have the Holy Spirit and you reject baptism, the devil's going to destroy you. Just like he did to me for 10 years. I'm telling you my experience, by the way, people. I experienced all these things. So let's continue. Okay. Count it all joy when you fall into various trials. Oh, and you will. Some people might not, though. Hopefully you don't. Knowing that the testing of your faith produces patience. When you go through with the Holy Spirit, you follow his guidance. There may be times, more than likely, I know I did, sin, I would fall into sin, I would practice it, then I'd repent. God will always take you back, but he will not be mocked, people. He'll take that Holy Spirit back. He did to me in 2012. So, if you fall into sin, the Holy Spirit is going to convict you, and you're going to know to repent. So if you slip up after you get the Holy Spirit, and you think, oh, I messed everything up, no. He doesn't withdraw he doesn't cut you off from 1, 2, or even 100 sins. It's when we make a practice of sins, and we have no intent to repent. That's insulting the spirit of grace, because Jesus died to bring us to repent. If we say we don't have to repent, it insults him. That's when God will cut you off. But if you make a mistake even seven times, if you fall into sin seven times, be the righteous man. Rise up seven times by repenting seven times. No matter how many times you fall into sin, do not give up. Because like it says, if you fall into sin, as long as you repent, count it as joy. Because you did what's righteous. You messed up. You made a mistake. Just like a kid. And you repent. You made things right. And you're going to be tested in your faith. So don't let the devil take you down. But let patience, once you get that Holy Spirit, give it time to grow on you. Just go with the word of the Lord, right? And let patience have its perfect work. The Holy Spirit is patient. It'll work perfectly through you. Just follow what Jesus, do whatever Jesus says, that you may be perfect and complete. Like I said, the Holy Spirit will help you perfect your loving, your keeping the commandments. It'll perfect your faith, and it makes you complete because it gives you the third part to help you along the way to your journey to heaven. And that's that. So where am I at with time? Okay. So remember, before we move on to the last scripture, and I'll show you how baptism saves you. 1 Corinthians chapter 12, verse 13, is Paul talking. For one, by one spirit, we were all baptized. All of us. How many? All of us into one body. So if you're baptized by water, okay. Now some people, remember, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, you must be baptized by water, baptized by the Holy Spirit, which is born of Spirit. Those three things is one baptism. So just like the Father, Son, Holy Spirit is three things, three parts, but one God. Same thing with baptism. Born of water, baptized by water, baptized by the Holy Spirit in the name of Jesus Christ. These three things equals one baptism. Father, Son, Holy Spirit, one God. One, two, three things in baptism, one baptism. Again, people, come on, we work together. All right, any questions? That don't hesitate. A lot of people question that. I could break it down like you wouldn't believe. All right, let's go. So, if anyone says they're baptized in the body, they're in the body of Christ, ask them. And they say they're not baptized, but they're in the body of Christ. Say, how did you get in the body of Christ if you're not baptized in the body of Christ? Right? Tell them to show you the scripture. How did you get in the body of Christ without getting baptized? They might have a scripture. I don't know. I didn't search that, but if you know one, give me one. Anyway, nobody's in the body of Christ that are baptized. You received the Holy Spirit before baptism and still got to be baptized. You might be in the body of Christ before that. I don't know. Whole nother story. Let's move on. So either way, you got to get baptized. Yeah. So we'll save that. Well, I guess we'll save that one for last. Okay. So yes, let's move along here. Okay. So now I'm going to get my thing. So let me reconnect these dots again and we'll go through it. So again, he who believes and is saved, you get baptized, baptism saves you, okay? You get born of water and spirit, and when you do that, you get complete and perfect, right, with the Holy Spirit. Can't do it by yourself. Without Jesus, you're lost. The devil will destroy you. And then we're going to go here, and let's go here. I'll just put this here. Okay, so Ephesians chapter 1, verse 13 and 14, very important, so pay close attention. Pay close attention. I'm running out of time. Okay. In him you also trusted after you heard the word of truth, the gospel of your salvation, in whom also having believed, that's after baptism, you were sealed with the Holy Spirit of promise, who is the guarantee of our inheritance until the redemption of the purchased possession to the praise of his glory. The guarantee does not mean, once saved, always saved. Let's get that straight. You still have to maintain and endure in the commands of Jesus. Love, repentance, and the one-time event of baptism. If you baptize, you ain't got to worry about that no more. Just love and repent when you mess up, all in the name of Jesus. Once you get baptized, you get Holy, that's what it comes down to. Love is the whole law. And repent when you mess up and be friends with Jesus, BFF. So in other words, in him, who is Jesus, in him, you also trusted. Do you trust the word of the Lord? The Lord says, get baptized, be saved. Do you trust him? I do. Jesus don't lie. Baptism saves you. Unless he lied. I think he told the truth. I believe that. Anyway, after you have heard the word of truth, what's the word of truth? That's the gospel of your salvation. What is the gospel of your salvation, my friends? Right up here, look. Right there. The gospel of your salvation is believe Jesus rose from the dead, and if you do, go get baptized. I just messed up. Go get baptized. And that's how you get saved. See? That's this belief. Go get baptized. Holy Spirit will go in you. And Holy Spirit will guide you the rest of the way, as we just went through. All right. And so if you hear the gospel, believe and be baptized. If you hear it, don't do it. You're deceiving yourself, right? Rejection of baptism, rejection of God's will. We'll do that next. So, in whom also having believed. Believed means after they're baptized. Look at a jealous. Oh, I should have bought that story. Okay, look at a jealous story. He repented. He seeked out God, right? When he said, what am I supposed to be saved? They said, believe in the word of the Lord and you'll be saved, you and your household. And then they preached the word of the Lord. Here's the word of the Lord. Believe and be baptized. That's what the jailer and his family was told. If you don't believe it, you're condemned. What the jailer and his family do next? Immediately, they went and got baptized. And because they obeyed after they were baptized, that's how they believed God. Believed God with the D at the end. They believed the. Just like here, they believe the after you get baptized, right? So after you get baptized, you obey the baptism, which means you believe the. And now you come out of the water, you got the Holy Spirit. And when you believe the, after baptism is when you were sealed with the Holy Spirit of promise. That's what happened with the Jelena family, right? Right? Who is the guarantee of our inheritance. So this is why baptism saves you. Again, when you believe Jesus rose from the dead and you trust what he says, go get baptized, you'll be saved. If you believe him, you'll be baptized. And when you get baptized, you put your works of baptism applied to your faith that makes your faith perfect, because you show God you love him by responding to the holy command of baptism. He gives you his love back by giving you the Holy Spirit, and the Holy Spirit completes you and perfects you and guarantees you heaven. And because you got baptized, you received the Holy Spirit. It's that Holy Spirit that guarantees your salvation. Reject baptism, you reject the Holy Spirit, you reject Jesus, you reject the Father, and that's a rejection of the Father's will. You won't go to heaven unless you got help from Jesus, and you need that Holy Spirit. So, because the Holy Spirit guarantees you heaven, that's why you're saved when you get baptized. How do we get the Holy Spirit? You do what Jesus says. You get born of water, baptized. You repent, get baptized, and receive the Holy Spirit. Boom. So, and that's why baptism saves you. Because once you baptize, you get the Holy Spirit, it guarantees you heaven, which is why you're saved, duh. Because you obeyed, duh. Because you believed, duh. After baptism, you became a friend of God because you kept his command. When you call him Lord, Lord, that's when we say we believe. But the question is, are you doing it? Which is the works of the Father's will. Those are the works that justifies, not the laws of works, but the law of love, which is called the law of faith. Love God, others, and yourself. Repent when you mess up and go back to loving, because sin is violation of love. And one time I've been in baptism to get the Holy Spirit, which guarantees your salvation. Remember, that guarantee comes with conditions. You have to maintain your faith. It's not once saved, always saved. That's a false doctrine from John Calvin. He thought you could murder people and have sex with your neighbor's wife and milk kill the husband. He said adultery and murder and everywhere in between, you won't lose it. You'll go to heaven for killing people. That's John Calvin. That's why they're called Calvinists. Once saved, always saved. False doctrine, people. Doctrines of demons. I got a couple minutes left. I'm running out of time. So, again, let me just break this down in a nutshell. Okay? So, now that we went through the details, hopefully someone learned. Let me know if someone's learning something. I don't want to hear your, oh, it's faith alone, you're preaching works. And when you understand a works-based salvation compared to a faith-based, the laws of works is a works-based salvation. Does not justify, doesn't prevent voting. Laws of works and the laws of faith, two different laws, two different works. Anyway, let's move on. Do I have enough time? Oh, okay. So, again, the gospel straight from the mouth of Jesus is whoever believes, which means to obey, and is baptized will be saved. If you get baptized, you'll be saved because baptism now saves you when you receive the Holy Spirit that guarantees you heaven. So once you get baptized, you go in the water, born of water, come out of the water. That's, well, born of water. You receive the gift of the Holy Spirit, which is called born of spirit, and it interchanges you because it completes you with the Godhead, your third part, the Holy Spirit, and it perfects your faith by helping you keep the commandments of Jesus, which maintains your repentance in your love towards God. And when you're done with that, you because you're perfected and you're saved because in him you also trust it, You obeyed the gospel of your salvation and believed. Remember, the God, okay, and the Holy Spirit. Once you get baptized, you receive, you get sealed with the Holy Spirit as promised. And it walks you into heaven, basically. That's what it does. And as long as you do what the gospel says and you believe by obeying the gospel, right? And you also have to believe baptism. Okay, now, I'm going to do like a 5-minute extra part on here and I'll tell you what happens to those who reject and refuse baptism. The ones who say they don't have to be baptized to be saved, I have to give the warning. For all good, there's always the devil trying to take your glory, people. I'm telling you, if you want your salvation, the devil wants to take it. So let me show you that next. Okay, so let me break this down. Okay, yeah. I'm messing something up. Okay, hold on, guys. Hold on. Can I blow that up? No, I guess that's it. Dang it, I had that. I guess that'll work. Okay, people. Now, as we see, we just went through whoever believes Jesus, which means to obey, are the ones who are baptized. The ones who don't believe what Jesus says because they don't believe in him, they say they believe him, they don't believe what he says. That's what hypocrites and Pharisees do, seriously. So if you believe in Jesus, just believe what he says. Just do what he says. Just do what he says. So what about the ones who do not believe Jesus? And they say they believe, but they disobey. Disobedience is unbelief. Look right here. We're going to get to that, okay? So the ones who do not believe, if they say they don't have to be baptized to be saved, they don't believe anything we just went through the scriptures in a previous section a few minutes ago. But the ones who do not believe, they're acting like a Pharisee. So they're acting like a Pharisee and lawyer who's rejecting the Father's will by rejecting baptism. Yes, baptism is the Father's will. Remember what Jesus says. Every word he speaks comes from the Father, which makes it the Father's will. So if you reject baptism, the preachers don't, they're not letting you know this stuff. They're not giving you warnings. They're telling you all the happy stuff, but they're not warning about the devil's stuff who can take it from you. Rejection of baptism is a rejection of the Father's will. And this, for it had been better for them not to have known the way of righteousness. You're going to wish you never heard baptism than after they have known it. To turn from the holy commandment given unto them. Why is baptism a holy commandment? Some people say it ain't. Go ahead, try to explain this. The Lord says, be holy, for he is holy. So keep his holy commandment of baptism so you can receive the Holy Spirit that makes you holy. Your third part is holiness, love. That's why the baptism is a holy commandment, because it gives you Holy Spirit, common sense. And but yeah, they reject the holy commandment of baptism delivered unto them, among other commandments, right? Jesus died and rose from the dead to establish his commandments to be true. As soon as he goes to the Father, they take his commandments and throw it out. It's like pissing on his grave. It's insulting to the Spirit of grace. That's a whole nother story, though, because they disobey, but they deny him by disobeying. Anyway, so when they turn away from the holy command, because someone convinced them they never have to be baptized, well, and God swore, to whom did he swear that they would not enter his rest, but to those who do not obey? So we see that they could not enter in his rest because of unbelief. People, the ones who do not obey are the ones who do not believe. Disobedience is the exact definition of not believing in Jesus. When they disobey, they do not believe in him. That's what the Bible defines unbelief about. Unbelief means they don't believe what he says. So because they do not obey baptism, right? They don't obey, so they do not believe. Because they disobey baptism, they will be condemned because of their unbelief. Disobedience is the same exact definition as unbelief, which means what it means to believe in Jesus is obedience. Obeying Jesus is what it means to believe in Jesus. You got to trust what he says, because if you don't do what Jesus says, they don't trust the finished work on the cross, because he says be baptized. They say they trust him, they just don't trust what he says. They're hypocrites. Anyway, and because Nobody told the preachers and the babes in Christ that obedience is the definition of belief, and disobedience is unbelief. Go figure. Remember, not everyone who calls him Lord who says they believe will be saved, but only the ones who does the Father's will. Not the ones who reject it by rejecting baptism. Common sense, people. It's not faith alone. It's not free grace theology. Whole nother story. Anyway, so because they did not obey, because of their unbelief, they didn't believe. They said they believe in Jesus. They just didn't believe what he says. Hypocrites. Anyway, oh foolish Galatians, who has bewitched you from obeying the truth? Huh? What's the truth? Well, does Jesus lie? Of course not. Jesus tells the truth. So what's the truth? The same thing that Jesus that came out of the mouth of Jesus. If you get baptized, you'll be saved. Question, do you believe in the truth? Baptism saves you. That's what Jesus is saying right there. Do you believe in Jesus? Well, no, they don't. And that's why they're foolish, because they do not believe. That's foolishness. They say they believe in Jesus, but it's so foolish not to believe what he says and to disobey it, which means they don't believe in him. The ones who love Jesus keep his commandment of baptism as well as the other ones. The ones who do not love Jesus, Jesus is very clear that they're the ones who disobey his word, such as baptism. They don't love him. So they say they love him with their mouth. They say they believe and have faith with their lips, but because they disobey him, their hearts are far from him, which means they don't believe him because they're sons of disobedience. They reject the holy commandment given unto them, and without even knowing it, they were deceived into rejecting the Father's will without their knowledge. People, read your Bible. Whatever the preacher man says at your church, you better check your Bible to make sure he ain't lying. There's a reason why I don't go to church no more. Nobody around here seems to believe the full gospel. They believe the believing part. They don't believe in baptism. They're hot on belief, cold on baptism. That means they're a lukewarm Christian. They only believe half the gospel. People, I warn you, I've been doing this for over like 25 years. 25 years I've been doing this. I'm telling you right now, there's not one scripture in the Bible that supports baptism as an option. As you see, if you reject baptism, you could, look, let's go one more time and I'm done. I'll take it up to a couple more minutes. Okay, so if you do not believe, then you're rejecting the Father's will by not being baptized. Therefore, you turned away from the holy command delivered unto you. So therefore, you're not going to heaven, because if you do not obey, that means you do not believe. Therefore, because they do not obey disobedience, they've been foolish Galatians, and they were bewitched from obeying the truth. And the truth that they disobeyed was that baptism now saves you, as Jesus confirms. So if your preacher man says baptism is an option, he's not a bad person. Let me tell you what to do. If you have the balls to question your pastor, I do it all the time. That's what I don't like when I go to church. They don't like me when I go to church. I always got something to say. Here's the thing. There's a difference between deceivers and the ones who's been deceived. What I see in the world today in my area, most people who say baptism is an option and it doesn't save you, first of all, that's a heresy, because they go complete opposite of Jesus. When God says, don't eat from the tree or you die, there's a command, there's a warning. Serpent comes in and says, disobey God's command and ignore the warning. So go get baptized, you'll be saved. That's a command. Here's the warning. If you don't believe, you'll be condemned. Satan comes in and says, baptism doesn't save you. Disobey Jesus. And then he gets you to ignore the warning. Same thing as the garden. Same thing. Disobey Jesus, ignore the warning, sin against God, go to hell. Satan eats your soul up with his children dying. You got children, if he's going to feed your soul. Never mind. Anyway, let's continue. So anyway, people, I warn you. Show your pastor these scriptures. They're not taught. They went to Bible school. That's the problem. Bible school don't teach Bible no more. They teach John Calvin, Martin Luther, and that Joseph Smith dude. And then they mix them all together, and out comes the Antichrist called free grace theology. Or a complete license to completely disobey Jesus, which means they don't believe. Obedience is belief. Disobedience is unbelief. I got about less than 2 minutes left, so I'm going to end this. People, I just want everyone to go to heaven. And all you faith learners, free gracers, and once saved, always savers, you can hate me all day long, but God still loves you, and I still forgive you, because that's the way of the Lord. Imitate Christ. If Jesus says it, you better do it. If anyone says the opposite of Jesus, They're incorrect. But take these scriptures to your pastor and teach your pastor baptism does save you. If anyone rejects baptism, they reject the Father's will. Only an idiot with the delusion, the stupidness God gave them because of their disobedience would believe they can reject God's will and still go to heaven after turning away from Holy Communion, showing Jesus how much they don't love him. Come on, people. Common sense. It's very simple. You believe he rose from the dead, you go get baptized. I've seen people, they'll spend their whole life using the word of God to reject the word of God instead of spending an hour just to go down to your church, get baptized, to show them they love him. They'd rather show God they don't love him by rejecting him and twisting the word of God. Me? People use the word of God to reject the word of God. I'm a defender of the word of the Lord and the gospel of Jesus Christ. I use the word of God to defend the words of Christ. All scripture breathed by God, scripture cannot be broken. If anyone takes one scripture to break another scripture, to reject a scripture, they have broken scripture. Not one word will be done away with that dropped out of the mouth of Jesus. Not even one jot. My question, who says baptism is an option? Why do you take the words of Jesus and you do away with the whole command of baptism that you have to also reject dozens of scriptures to defend your man-made doctrines? If scripture is broken by man-made doctrines, it's a false doctrine. People, I've been studying and researching false doctrine. I'm telling you this right now. I know evil when I see it. Disobedience is evil. It's the work of the devil. He who sins is of the devil. What's sin? Sin is when you disobey God. If he says don't eat from that tree and you eat from the tree, disobedience, that's sin. And if you practice it, you practice lawlessness. You go to hell for that. And all sin is of the devil, keeping you enslaved. Go get back, believe Jesus rose from the dead, truly in your heart. Take your heart close, obey him. Once you keep all his commands, you go get baptized. Well, just repent for an hour, one day repent. Go get baptized real quick, get that Holy Spirit, and watch it work through you. But be patient and let it work, let it work. If you slip up, just keep at it. Righteous man rises seven times. I'm out of time. Anyway, I hope someone learned something today. If anyone has any questions, do not hesitate to ask. If anybody wants to reject what scripture says, good luck trying that with me. Like I said, I got 25 years here, people. I know what I'm doing. I do what Jesus says it, I preach it. You should too. Remember, every single preacher who truly believes in Jesus preaches what Jesus preaches, and that's the gospel. Believe and be baptized. Believe and be baptized. Believe. What's the gospel? Believe and be baptized. What's baptism? What's believing? That's the gospel. Believe and be baptized. What's the gospel? Believe and be baptized. Anyway, you know what? Y'all ain't sneezed, but God blesses you anyway. If you hate me, I forgive you, and I'll pray for you. In the name of Jesus Christ, may God be with all you all, be with you all. And the ones who reject the word of God, I'll pray that God will smack you away. I pray that God will hit you with the truth and remove the delusion of stupidness for being disobedient to the one who died for you. Respect the man of the land and keep his commands. That rhymed. I just noticed that rhymed. God bless you all. Amen. All right.
There is unrest in the forest. There is trouble with the trees. For the maples want more sunlight.